Hello everyone and welcome to Imani's Lightwork Keys to Akasha section of my channel. If you are a new subscriber or you're just visiting, welcome, okay? If you've been here from the beginning of time, I truly appreciate your continuous love and support, okay? Before I go into what case I'm going to be covering today, I just want to lay down a few ground rules of this section of my channel, okay? So, first off, all of these cases that I do, they're solely based on channeling and interpretation, which means that I'm using my ability and the aid of spirit to complete the cases, to get the readings done, to get all the details in that I need, spirit fields that I need, etc. Okay? If you do have an inquiry about this section of my channel, please feel free to send me an email to ifadivination777@gmail.com or send me a direct message on my IG at ImaniIfe777. Okay, I'm always on there, so you can send me a message at any time. I typically respond, promptly. Okay, so the case that I'm going to be covering today will be for Destiny Harrison. This was a requested case by a subscriber. Okay, so before I go into her case, I'm just going to give you guys, you already know the news story, what happened to her, but I just want to pretty much reiterate that information to you before I truly get started. Okay, so Destiny Harrison, she was born April 16th, 1999. That would be making her age 21. She was an Aries and she passed December 21st of last year, 2019. Okay, so the situation is that they claim that one or two gunmen came into her. She was a salon owner. She was an entrepreneur. She was a young black businesswoman. Very young indeed to own a salon, I believe so myself. Madame D Beauty Bar. Okay, so she would be, she would be 22 years old this year. Okay, she would be 22. And I believe that she was complaining about, there was a situation where she feared for her life. She experienced some sort of a break-in December 9th. So she pretty much was living in fear. The spirit is emphasizing the point that she may have been living with fear. I wouldn't say totally living in fear. I would say she may have had an air of paranoia around her aura. That could have been a possibility. Okay, so let's see what's going on here. She's telling me that she heard a conversation happening. So, days prior, she could have heard a conversation happening days prior to her passing. This could be days prior. But the neighborhood. So, going to her shop every day, communicating with people every day, seeing certain people every day. This is a situation here where she's in her town, she's in her neighborhood, but heard cryptic conversation. She may have heard a cryptic conversation happening between two men. She had a really cryptic conversation happening between two men in the area that she lived in. Okay, you know what's coming to mind? I don't know if this is like the sign of Aquarius, I don't know if one of the perpetrators necessarily was an Aquarian, someone that lived close to her, or someone that kept an eye on salon. Someone that kept their eye on her salon may have been an Aquarian, or somebody, one of those men, it could be Aquarian female, one of those men that she's saying, there were two men that kept watching her, stalking her, watching her salon, keeping a close eye on her whereabouts, when she was going to be there, etc. One of them, one of those men, it could be multiple men, yes, one of those men, I feel, could be an Aquarian, or their friend. Some, there's a, like, it's giving me a male feeling that someone, it was an Aquarian energy stalking her. Someone was an Aquarian energy that was stalking her. But let's see what's going on here. Watching her, stalking her, or this is that's more so associated with the energy of her being watched in and out of her salon, or her hearing cryptic conversations between two dudes. It just depends on what's going on there, okay? All right, destiny. Ten of Pentacles energy is underneath, okay? Ten of Pentacles energy has to do with a lot of money, but had more than one bank account. She may have had more than one bank account, one for savings. I believe she had a child as well, so I would understand that she may have been, you know, if you're a mom, you're saving money for your daughter. Ten of Pentacles typically represents family money as well, needing to give money to her mother or a sibling. I had groceries when I said it. So when I said mother and sibling, she may have been helping those particular family members to groceries using her store money to help her mother get groceries for herself and her daughter, etc. The one to close, there's this energy also of wanting to, or having the thought of having to want to close I almost said appointment, but it's giving me this feeling of like a bank setting also. Like a bank, accounts and things of that nature. I keep feeling this feeling of wanting to close it. Like she may have wanted to close an account that she had open. She could have had more than one account open, but it's giving me this feeling. I keep getting this energy of wanting to close. So this could be the wanting to close, could be wanting to close down. I don't feel like this would be her business. I feel like this is connected to a feeling that she has about an account that she had open, but she is tampered. When I said account that she had open, it was being tampered by, I guess, someone in the bank. It was being tampered by someone that was working in the bank that she had the account in, but mother managed. So when I said that her mother may have been helping her keep it. And she was young. She was only 21 years old. So she's almost She's recently legal to do certain things. So in terms of accounts, it wasn't well versed. In terms of having accounts, she may not have been well versed. And that could be where the mother is coming in and saying, you know, I'm going to help you open up this account so you could put your money in it for us, or for yourself, for your daughter, etc. But every time I go on these examples, she wanted to close. So it's an account that her mother may have helped her open, or she could have opened it herself, but the mother could have been there, yes, to guide her, show her, you know, this is the ID that you need. You need birth certificate. You need this, that, and third. You need to sign here. So, you know what this feels like? Like, if she went to the bank with her mother, you know how typically people are kind of like a cosign, you know, typically people that are like 18, just above 18, 19, 20 years old, 21 years old, they, in some cases, they feel more comfortable with their parents. They feel more comfortable with their parents signing certain things for them. And that could be, you know, the application process. That could be the kind of interaction that she had with her mother. Can you help me open up this account? Can you manage this account for me, etc.? So I do feel like she could have had an account open that she wanted to close, but the reason for wanting to close it, or one, she could have had multiple of them open, or one or two. The reason for wanting to close it was because somebody in the bank was tampering with it, or someone was just tampering with it. But they didn't tell mother. So someone tampering with it, she could have found that out precisely. But she may not have told her mother that, hey, the bank called me today. Someone went into it. The bank called me today and said somebody went into my account somehow. Somebody hacked into my, I got a hold of credit card. Somebody got a hold of my credit card. You can have multiple credit cards. Yes, you can have multiple Visas, this, that, and the third credit cards, whatever it is that she had going on. But mother helped her get, I feel like her mother is like the foundation of the situation in terms of her, any financial affairs that she may have had to take care of. She's still kind of young. She still needs to be well-versed in certain areas here. So she's got accounts open. She's got credit cards. She's got an account that something is going on where somebody in the bank or someone somehow is tampering with that account. She's got credit cards that need to turn off. She's got credit cards or a credit card that needs to be turned off. But obviously the reason for why one or however many of those credit cards that she has, the reason for why they need to be turned off is because the bank account is being compromised by someone. So it just depends on what's going on. But something there she did not tell her mother. Something there, she wanted to handle it herself. She may not have told her mother that was happening. Something there was happening to her for a while or days prior, or just something like that was happening, and she may have wanted to show her mother, hey, I got this without your help. So she may not have told her mother that the bank called me today and recommend shut down something. The bank called me today, recommend I shut something, close something, shut off card, do this, that, and the third. She didn't, something there she didn't tell her mother. She wanted to handle it herself. Because the mother made protective. The mother may have been really protective with, especially her financial affairs and owning a business. The mother may have been really protective there. And it depends on what's going on. The starting point has the Six of Cups energy. So cups represent, I don't know what her mother's sign is, but cups, conversation, the cups energy, the Six of Cups represents some type of, it represents energy from the past or some type of recent, not on the day, some type of recent situation. That's why I said days prior or hours prior or weeks prior, weeks ago, months ago, some type of returning, some type of conversation, just happened to be returning. I had a cousin also. This is a cups energy. There's a lot of, it's giving me this heavy family feeling. So, separate from her mother, but the Six of Cups energy could be she's telling me something, there's something going on here with a cousin or a conversation that she had money, a conversation that she had with a cousin about, but didn't want to give, a conversation she had. This was a family money and saving money, having accounts open for herself and family. You know, the thing about family and running your own business and this, that, and the third, leech, the spirit agrees with what I'm going to say. It already picks up that energy from the back of my pineal gland. So what's happening there is that, what's happening with it is that the thing about family and running your own business, they keep a close eye. The spirit is emphasizing the point. Family keeps a close eye, especially if you're doing well. The cousins and brothers and sisters and aunts and aunt leeches. I'm going on these examples, and there are some interesting going on with certain family members, not her mother, certain family members that she has. Her mother and her child would be more so immediate, like immediate family. They're immediate, so they're pretty much exempt from the example I'm about to give right now. But what's going on here is that she's got cousins, distant cousins, and cousins that complain about money. She's got cousins, distant cousins, etc. They're complaining to her about money. Or they're just asking her for, they don't want, every time I go on these examples, she didn't want to give them, kept complaining. She didn't want to give some type of family member money, or some people call their friends their cousins. I don't really understand. Some people call their friends their cousins, or this could legitimately be a cousin that kept loaned. This legitimately could be a cousin that she's interacting with, that they're coming to her and they're asking her, you know, can I borrow, what's a decent amount of money, can I borrow Can I borrow 100? Can I borrow 250? Can I borrow 300? This could be a situation here. It's a six also. This could be a situation here where she's got a cousin that kept changing the amount of money. She's got some type of family member that they're coming to her. That one day they're asking her for 50. One day they're asking her for, I'm trying to go by tens. They're asking her for 50. Then they're asking her for 100, 150, 150, 200, 250, 300. They're going up by 50. They're going up by tens, counting by tens, but needed to stop. So when I said that something like that was happening with a cousin, some type of our friend, and something about that, she may have been complying with someone in the beginning, but when they started, okay, she may have been complying with someone in the beginning, but once they started increasing the amount of money that they kept asking her for, she tried to cut that off, but they kept coming back and asking for more. Every time they came back, I want 50, I need 100, I need to cover my car bill. I need to do this, that, and the third. All of a sudden, I'm $300 short off of my rent money, etc. But that kept happening to her. So this is a cup's energy. Something like that kept happening to her with a friend, or a friend she called her cousin, or it's a blood cousin that kept asking for money. And this is a cup's energy trying to explain something to them also. This is a cup's energy here is that she kept trying to explain something to a family member or a friend. But for some reason, they're not understanding her perspective. For some reason, they're not understanding her perspective. It could be either her destiny's perspective, or she herself may not have been understanding the family member's perspective, their explanation. She didn't understand the family member's perspective. It has something to do with their explanation into why they even needed the money. It just depends on what somebody could have been trying to buy weed or something. Somebody could have been some type of expense that somebody else had she couldn't afford anymore, or she just couldn't afford it, or they were just asking for money and she kept turning. It could have been okay in the beginning. 50 was okay, 100 is okay, but if you're trying to go up to like $300, that's too much. I she could have been trying to explain that to someone. I have children. My mother needs this, that, and the third. I have a daughter to take care of and things of that nature. But someone is greedy. So when was greedy with dealing with a family member or a friend, or they weren't understanding her for some reason, or she was not understanding why they even need so much money. She didn't understand why they needed so much money at a particular time. Just depends on what's going on. And they keep coming back over and over. A friend, a cousin, some type of but their affiliation. So when I said a friend or cousin, something's also going on there with a friend or a cousin. Their affiliation. Somebody that her cousin or friend was affiliated with kept asking for money. If it's not only her cousin or a friend, someone that was attached to her friend or her cousin, their affiliation kept trying to get the ends. Hold on a second. Wait a minute here. She's got a cousin. She's got a cousin or a friend, and something's going on with them with needing money, but they invited somebody in. Something's going on with a friend or a cousin. They needed money, but what's happening with it is that that friend and or that cousin is they're bringing some type of separate affiliate that they have into that money giving situation. Needed to, every time I go on these examples, she keeps saying I needed to cut off. I had to cut off. The cut off was necessary to happen, but made somebody angry. The cut off was necessary to happen, but it was making somebody upset. A friend, a cousin. But the reason for why. One situation with it is that I keep getting don't understand perspective. Like the reason for it is somebody really wasn't understanding. She really wasn't understanding them, or they really were not understanding her perspective for some reason. But it could have something to bring somebody in. It could have something to do with the fact that she's got a cousin / friend that they're just willingly bringing their own friend. They're willingly bringing their own friend. Or their own, some type of affiliate that was attached to the cousin. Dangerous. An affiliate that her cousin or a friend was attached to was dangerous. I'm going to go with cousin. A blood cousin that she had, their affiliate. A blood cousin that she had, their affiliate or their girlfriend, their what it could be, a dude, their girlfriend, their some type of friend or affiliate that her blood cousin had. Someone was dangerous about that person. They weren't receiving. Someone was dangerous about that external person. They weren't receiving anything. That's why. So the Queen of Cups energy is in the waiting position here. I would spend so much time on one card. The Queen of Cups energy is here, but that's her. The Queen of Cups energy, she's saying that's her. Queen of Cups energy, Cancerian female, Pisces, Scorpio female, but they're affiliates. So something's going on. They're affiliates. Like they're affiliate. I don't know if this person could be a cousin. This person is all these cups energies that are coming through. This person could be, I keep getting their affiliate. This person could be one of her cousins or a friend, but something's going on with their own separate affiliate of some kind. Yes, this would be her affiliate, her family member or cousin, but somebody that is attached to them that she knows or doesn't know, that is attached to them, like singular by themselves. I keep getting dangerous. That whoever that person is a dangerous person, but kept trying to explain that to her. So the Queen of Cups energy, the Queen of Cups, okay. Either Destiny was explaining, wow, that's a lot. Either Destiny was talking to a Queen of Cups and their dangerous friend. The Destiny could have pulled the Queen of Cups energy aside to have a conversation about their own affiliate, but saw them do something. So she could have, Destiny could have pulled this person aside to have a conversation with them. Something, I saw your friend do something really sketchy one day, you know. I saw your affiliate do something really, but didn't believe her. So she's trying to help me. They didn't believe her. Like the Queen of Cups energy did not believe that Destiny saw their, it's really convoluted. The Queen of Cups energy did not believe, or they weren't trying to believe that Destiny saw their own separate affiliate do something with the money. That Destiny saw their own affiliate do something really interesting with the money that Destiny was giving this person. That's why she cut them off. So she's trying to help me. That's why she cut off, or she tried to cut off a cousin slash friend. Something's going on with their own. Something's going on separately with their own affiliate that she's saying was a dangerous person, but using the money wrongly. She's saying that the Queen of Cups energy affiliate that she was the Queen of Cups energy, that's like a cousin or a friend, direct, an immediate family member, that she's saying that they're attached to someone that's dangerous. That person, that separate person, Destiny is saying that she saw do something really interesting with the money, and that's why I said somebody not understanding her perspective and not explaining to her what exactly friend do. What exactly did you see my friend do? And that's why the Six Cups energy is there. What did you see my friend do? She's got a cousin that she's willingly giving. She has some type of cousin or friend that she's willingly giving money to. They're attached to one situation with the conversation is that one situation that Destiny doesn't understand is why am I giving this person? Why am I giving this person hundreds of dollars? Why am I giving this person hundreds of dollars week after week? What are they, cousin? Something there is residing with some type of cousin or friend. This is Destiny's question to herself. Why am I giving this person hundreds of dollars week after week after week? Not using intuition. So when I said that Destiny may not have been using her intuition, that a Queen of Cups energy that she was helping out. She was helping out that person, but Destiny wasn't using her intuition that the person that she's helping to large amounts, the person or the friend, the cousin that she's helping to large amounts of money week after week, is they're giving it to, I keep getting dangerous. They're sharing that money with someone that's dangerous. And Destiny could have met that person. Yes, yes, she could have met that person. Had a run-in with, they went to the salon. She had run-ins with that person. They went to the salon. The cousin, their affiliate, went, may have been getting their hair done in the salon or whatever. Some type of situation. It could be a dude or a female, or they would just buy the salon. It is dependent. That's why I said she saw conversations happening outside her salon, the cousin's friend. She saw conversations happening around the salon, but it has something to do with the cousin's friend. But one is a female. So the cousin that she was helping out with money, has like two or three affiliates here that she's saying one of them is a female. So it's giving me like the female vibe, and it could also be a male vibe that the cousin is willingly giving her money to. The cousin or the friend was willingly giving Destiny's money to some dude. Destiny's money to another external female. They kept stalking her, to an external female. Could be another Queen of Cups, to an external female that was watching and stalking. So Destiny's got like, Destiny is in this situation here where the affiliates, I'm touching the Queen of Cups, these energies, they're affiliates. Her affiliates have affiliates that toxic. Her affiliates have affiliates that are toxic. They're dudes. It's an external dude that's attached to Queen of Cups. Can you ask Destiny $100? Can you ask Destiny for $100 so I can drug deal? Can you ask Destiny for $100, $200 so that I can complete this drug deal, so I can get this drug deal running, but drug money. So what's happening with it is that her Destiny's hard-earned cash from her salon or her own cash is drug money. It's something, part of it is ending up turning into drug money because of their affiliate, because of a Queen of Cups energy affiliate. Her cousin has some type of toxic male or female attached to her, drugs, and that's why the spirit kept emphasizing that this energy's affiliates were toxic because somebody's on drugs, somebody's selling drugs, somebody needs a base amount of money to get a drug deal somebody needs a base amount of money to get the drug deal, to get a drug deal to be completed. It just depends on what's going on, but she should go to jail. So I'm looking at Queen of Cups energy. She should go to jail. A cousin affiliate, somebody should go to jail there. They orchestrated some type of situation. They're the ones that kept asking. So the Queen of Cups, and they're the ones that kept asking. They're the ones that are asking for $300 every other week. They're asking for $100 for a dude. They're asking for that money also for a dude. They're asking for that money for a female, kept stalking her. They're asking, Queen of Cups energy asking Destiny for that amount of money constantly for a female. For a female that they often visited her salon but was envious. So when I said that, they're attached to someone, or that could be them also. They're visiting her salon. They're affiliate. They themselves are visiting her salon, her cousin, a friend, whatever, whoever they are. They're also attached to another female that became envious. They're attached to another female that became envious. That female, I'll go with the female first. That female that this person is attached to, befriended. She, Destiny, may have befriended at one point. She herself, Destiny, may have befriended the Queen of Cups energy affiliate, her cousin's friend. She befriended them. Every time I go on these examples, her cousin had a friend that was stalking her. But one element of what her not using her intuition is about that is because they following her into salon. Someone was following her into the salon, watching her in the salon. But she's not using, something's going on with her where Destiny, but she wasn't using her intuition at one point where she, the girl that's following, was being given the money, the girl that's following her into the salon, outside of the salon, she's being given by cousin. She's that girl, that one girl is being given that money by Destiny's cousin or Destiny's friend. But Destiny doesn't know close affiliation. Destiny is unaware of that close affiliation. This element is also giving, this element asking Destiny for money, also giving this element, okay, this element asking Destiny for, this is situation two. This element asking Destiny for money, attached to a dude, drug deal, attached to a dude that is there. They're trying to orchestrate a drug deal with Destiny money, but watching her outside of store. So that they're cut her cousin, friend or whatever, that they're attached to the money that Destiny's giving them. They're giving it to a dude to have orchestrated a drug deal outside of the store. So Destiny is a convoluted. Destiny is in a convoluted situation between some type of really interesting affiliation that a cousin/friend has. Mistake. So when I said something there was a mistake, wow. That's a lot that you got to be careful with family and friends and giving people money. You don't know what people are doing. Especially if there's some type of interesting drug tie with family member. Some type of interesting drug tie between Destiny's family member and Destiny's cousin. Whatever it is going on. But Destiny's cousin friend caused a problem. Destiny, whatever time I say cousin, her cousin caused a problem. Friend caused a problem. She's given the money. She keeps coming and asking Destiny every week or every month, coming and ask, can I borrow $100? But doesn't know what the money's for. Can I borrow $100? She's not telling Destiny what the money's for. Who she's giving the money to. So who the cousin is giving the money to, problematic. Who the cousin is giving the money to, that person, that guy, that girl is problematic. Something's problematic about them. Something is toxic about that person, problematic about them. Or it's a problematic situation, whatever it is. There's your intuition card. I just said intuition with the High Priestess, but she needs to leave. High Priestess energy, Queen of Cups energy need to leave. She's not using, why is she coming back asking me, why is she standing by the door awkwardly? Somebody may have been by the door, but I get across the street. Somebody may have been watching her from this is a lot of information. Somebody may have been watching her across from somewhere across the street from the store, diagonal from the store. Somebody was watching her, like somebody, a cousin. I don't feel like the cousin would be moving that way with her awkwardly. I just feel like they're affiliate. I just feel like it's the affiliate that was attached to the cousin or the friend that was doing oddity, that they were doing that kind of audit. But it happened. I don't feel like that's a one day thing. I don't feel like that was a one day thing. I feel like ongoing. I feel like that's that was an ongoing situation. Every time I say this, it's a heavy going on with cousin friend. The spirit keeps like bringing that in my ear. The cousin's friend, her friend's affiliate, some type of the cousin's friend. But the stalker, the cousin's friend was a stalker of some kind. They set up someone to, I feel like they themselves were stalking her. And if it's another female, they themselves were stalking her to the extreme. They became envious and jealous, whatever. They themselves were stalking her to the extreme where they're asking for hair to be done. They're asking for their hair to be done. They're coming in the salon watching her. That's their way of stalking her. They're coming into the salon. Can you do my nails? Can you do my hair? Can you give me a lace front? Can you do this? Whatever. Can you give me a trim? Can you give me a washing set? Whatever it is that they're coming in and they're asking for. But they're doing that, getting closer to her. They're doing that awkwardly also. Someone is mentally going on with someone doing that because money. Someone is mentally going on with someone because this is crazy. An element about this is crazy. I keep getting cousin's friend. Her cousin's friend. Her friends, or a friend she called her cousin, whatever. Their affiliate kept getting hair done. Their affiliate kept coming in to get their hair done. That's why the High Priestess is, why did she need her hair done all every day like this? The cousin, my God. That's why I said something mentally is going on, interesting with somebody, where this is crazy. Something here is going on with someone that is mentally is going on with somebody. All right, how to go through this. Her cousin. Okay, let me just retract for a couple of minutes. Her cousin kept asking Her cousin kept asking for money, but the cousin, is for them to help their own friend. But kept coming to get something about that person. Something about that person. They kept coming to get the hair done. But it's not a one day thing. That person has a sociopathic kind of personality where they're coming in and they're asking for their hair to be done one day, but they're back the day after that. They're back Monday. They come in one. Okay, I'll just give you this example. They come in Monday. They're getting a trim done. They come in Tuesday, nails. They come in Tuesday, they want their nails done. They're coming in They're coming in Wednesday. They want their hair dyed, whatever. But tactics, something there was something, somebody was doing that, like some type of repetitious pattern. Were coming in her salon often back to back because a cousin. It could be a cousin that was doing that, or the cousin's friend, whatever it is. But somebody's doing it. Something sociopathic about somebody doing that. Or mentally, someone's mental, because it's stalking. It's someone's mentally sociopathic going on with it, because some element about doing that day after day, it implied that someone was stalking her. Implied that the cousin, it's one high priestess, one situation, her cousin, she's not using her intuition that the cousin's asking for money. She's finding out that the cousin is giving the money. She's finding out the cousin's giving the money to her friend or some, or whatever. But what's happening, and she's trying to cut Destiny's trying to cut that situation off. But what's happening with it is that Destiny isn't using her intuition that once she tries to make that cut off, that person is going to end up stalking her. That person, but the way that external girl is doing it is by coming into the salon, unnecessary things done, coming into the salon day after day to have unnecessary things done to her all the time, to get her nails done, to get feet done, to get hit. But it's like day after, it's odd because it's like day after day. Why does somebody need to come into the salon 5 days a week, day after, or every other day? But they don't want to make something obvious. So the cousin's friend or her friend's, whatever, cousin, whatever it is, they didn't want, it could be her friend's cousin or if her cousin's friend, her friend's cousin, whatever it is, somebody didn't want to make something obvious as well. So this is like coming into the salon on Monday and coming back on Thursday. Something weird like that for some type of unnecessary hair job, whatever it is. But it's, she wasn't using her into why they keep coming back. Why do they keep coming back? Why are they standing by the door? Or her cousin, her affiliate, the cousin's affiliate may have been hanging around the salon like that, talking to a dude outside, wasn't receiving money. They're outside. They're talking about that. Destiny made some type of cutoff, but she wasn't, the cousin's friend wasn't receiving money anymore. Whatever it is. Or the cousin, her own cousin wasn't, she made the cutoff. Her Destiny deciding to make the cutoff between a cousin, with giving a cousin money all the time, that one is like a domino effect. That one cutoff sent someone off. That one cutoff sent somebody's affiliate off, sent cousin affiliate off. That's one element that caused the stalking. That affiliate that's attached to the cousin, she's not realizing that something there is happening with her money like that. They're outside the store talking to some type of dude. Cousin caused the issue. I feel like the cousin, a cousin that she had, that, or a friend she called her cousin, but they seriously caused the issue, or their affiliate was greedy. That affiliate caused the issue. The affiliate is outside the salon watching the salon every move that I keep getting. Sociopath. Something is sociopathic about a cousin. Something is sociopathic about the cousin friend, cousin affiliate, whatever. Something sociopathic about, or something mentally is going on with somebody stalking her all the time. But it's because of a cutoff. The cutoff means I'm not giving you any more money to give to someone else. Destiny herself could have been finding out that someone, Destiny herself could have been finding out what, who her, who, okay, Destiny herself could have been finding out who the cousin was giving her money, her hard-earned money to. Like, large, it was fine in the beginning. Large amounts of money day after day. Why, she made the cutoff. Why is this guy outside having the conversation about my store? Why are they having this conversation about my store? Wow. About the store, they were just hanging around it, but annoyed her. So hanging around it, it annoyed her. But one element about them hanging around the store, she's not aware. She doesn't know what the reason for why they're hanging around the store. Hence the reason from the beginning with the accounts, a cousin friend. When I said accounts, something's going on with the cousin's friend with her accounts, or they tamper with her accounts. So she's like, I have to cut off these accounts. If something got really bad, borrowing money, something got really bad with somebody, somebody kept borrowing money from her. Obviously, I felt that that would have been an issue. Somebody kept borrowing money from her. But the person that was borrowing money from her was a druggie. So the person that was borrowing money from her all the time was giving it to a druggie. The druggie is stalking the store, watching, surveillancing her store day after day. They're coming by the store at, they're coming by the store trying to pretend that they need blue hair dye. They need lace front. They need whatever randomness that they need. They don't really need it. Watch her. They don't really need it. They just want to watch her. Like, they just want to keep a close eye on her constantly because of a cutoff. So because of the cutoff, somebody designed a plan to tamper with her accounts and they, but stole ID. Somebody designed a plan to tamper with her accounts and things of that nature. They stole her ID, or they got a hold of her ID card. Some type of ID. She could have gotten her ID at 18. I don't know how it is down there in, what was it, Baltimore, but she had to make some cutoffs with them. She had to close the accounts and close this, that, and the protection. She had to close an account and things of that nature for protection because something became really heated. I keep getting cousin friend. Something became really heated with her cousin's friend. And she's not realizing that it's becoming heated. And somehow that person got a hold of her ID. That's why they were coming into the store. They got a hold of her IDs, her personal information. Somehow she could have kept it in the store. She just had it. That she had it on her somehow. And somebody took a picture of it. She had it. Destiny had her information, ID cards on her in the store. Somebody managed to snap a picture of that ID. Somebody managed to snap. That could be why. Oh, I understand what's happening. That could be why somebody is coming into the store. That's why somebody's coming into the salon asking for random things to be done. Distract. It's supposed to distract Destiny so that that person could get a hold of her wallet and IDs and things of that nature at the salon somehow. So that they could snap. But it didn't work. So something there that somebody tried to do a tactic like that. Something about that didn't work for some reason. But something is sociopathic and druggy about that person that was doing that. Makes sense. That's why the High Priestess energy is there. Why are they outside my store like this all the time? But use a dress. Why are they outside my beauty salon like this all the time? They may have been writing her address down. But make fake ID. So writing her address down, they were doing that also so that they could try to figure out a way to. So if somebody was hooked up to come into the salon and ask for this, that, and the third done all the time, what's happening with that? Something about that may not have been working. So one idea of somebody doing that was to just take a picture of her ID, go in her purse, try to figure out a way to keep her distracted so that they could go into her bag and where she kept her ID and snap a picture of it. But something about that didn't work. So somebody's plan B was stand outside the store. Somebody's plan B was to stand outside the store or write her address down to create a fake ID. Oh, I see what's going on here. Somebody, if it's not snapping a picture of her actual ID or going in her bag or whatever, hooking up someone to distract her so they can go into her bag and take a picture of her photo ID. If it's not that, literally it's somebody coming by day after day to try to snap or get a perfect ID picture of her. But it had to be perfect. She had to be standing. She would have had to be in a position. This is like going into a store and somebody's unaware, pictures being taken. This is like going into a store. Somebody's unaware of somebody trying to get a perfect straight shot of somebody's, a perfect straight shot of somebody's picture, like right directly, so that it, but somebody tried to do that perfectly to create ID. Somebody tried to do that perfectly to create an ID, but they already have her address because they're standing out there. They already have her address because they're standing outside the store. So getting the address from her was not an issue. Needed to make fake ID. So what I'm going on these examples. Somebody needed to make a fake one. This is interesting. Like, I don't understand why somebody would have to go in somewhere and snap and get a direct shot of someone. They could, people go online and make copies, but it's like the pictures didn't look like ID pictures. The pictures that she may have had on her Facebook page or IG page, whatever page that she had, they may not have looked pleasant, I don't know what would be the right word to use. They may not have fit the description to, what do you call it, to be, you know, ID pictures usually have to be, they can't be pictures where you're just hanging out and lounging and those kind of things. And that could be why they somebody didn't bother with going on her social media outlets to copy and paste those pictures, because she may not have been they're not going, I don't know if they would even accept, I don't even think they would even accept an ID picture with her just hanging or her head to the side. Her head had to be perfectly straight. Like, it had to be perfectly, her shoulders literally not slouching. They had to be perfectly straight there. And that could be why somebody found it easier. That could be why somebody found it easier to try to snap a direct picture of her in the salon. And for some reason, she didn't notice that. Or she wasn't using her intuition. That's why they kept coming in. She wasn't using her intuition into why they kept coming in to do that. It's really interesting why somebody kept coming in or by somewhere to even do that. But she didn't notice. So that's one element about it. It caused stalking. That's one element. It caused someone. That's why somebody was stalking her. Friend, cousin's friend. That's why somebody was stalking. Somebody has some type of interest in an affiliate that wasn't receiving money anymore. So their idea was to snap a picture of her, get her home address, get her beauty salon address, so that they could make the ID. Perfectly. But the reason why they're doing that also is for them to get into her account. They're trying to figure out a way to get into her account. That's why they did that. That's why they were trying to do that. She's not using, why are they standing like that? She's not using their intuition, her intuition. Why are they coming in the salon? Why are they coming into the salon and watching me in this way? Or why are they trying to take pictures? This could literally be something that she experienced. This literally could be something that she experienced with just being in the salon. She would have to be unseen, you know what I mean? In order for someone to even do that, you know? I mean, I'm thinking that's why I said earlier on in the reading, something wasn't working with, they kept trying. Someone wasn't working about it, but somebody kept trying to do that. But something about it wasn't working. I mean, obviously something about it won't work. How are you trying to get somebody's picture like that? You know what I mean? They could have tried to go into the system, but somebody could have asked the cousin to find her ID online, or a picture of her ID online, or contact the bank to issue out a copy. Contact the bank where she had her account open to issue out a copy. And that could be something, that could be something the cousin did, or the cousin's affiliate did, a cousin friend did, to get the information that they need, so that they could benefit from her. She could have had an account open for the store, had a personal account open, multiple accounts open to keep the money section off precisely. Somebody's trying to create IDs with a photocopy of image. Somebody's trying to create an ID of her with a photocopy of her. But they need to go online or into the system. I keep getting some of the cousin. The cousin could have been helping with that. I don't know if she was aware that the cousin. I mean, she could have been open with that with the cousin. I don't know. Or somebody behind the scenes. Somebody could just been doing that behind the scenes for whatever reason. Somebody could have asked for permission. That's why I said six cups. And somebody could have asked permission to do so. But she could have. Oh, this is crazy. She could have given somebody that kind of permission, but abused it. At one point she did, but that person abused it by sharing it with a dangerous person. That person is stalking her, whatever it is. They're coming into the salon to gather whatever information that they need, to get addresses that they need. You know, whatever it is, it's crazy. The Libra, you have the sign of Libra with the Justice card is in the future there. So a Libra could be involved here. You have Libra, you have external Queen of Cups energies, water sign female there. and her instincts has the Seven of Swords energy. So the Seven of Swords energy, I keep getting a count. The Seven of Swords energy, swords kind of represent online to me. So she could have had online banking. I'm touching this card. Something's going on with online banking also. Or needing to sign into her, getting shock of life. Needed to sign into her online banking and getting the shock of her life. The spirit said shock of her life. She's signing into her online banking and she's noticing withdrawal. She's signing into her online banking and something's going on here where a withdrawal was made. A withdrawal was made. She did not make the withdrawal. I understand. She not knowing that somebody succeeded. That's why I said printing out photocopies of making photocopies of her image and making fake IDs with her name and things of that nature and addresses on them. It's so that somebody could get into the account and use it without her. It's so that somebody could get into her accounts and use the money without her permission. But what's happened? One element about that. She knows who did it, but I just gave her information. Look at the Queen of Cups energy. I just gave her information. I just gave my cousin information. I just gave my friend wrong move. I just gave my friend. I just gave my cousin the information. I didn't think that they dispersed. I didn't think that they would disperse my information to their own separate affiliates. Their own separate affiliates make copies. Their own separate affiliates make copies. They're making copies, but the copies that they're making is allowing them to sign in. It's allowing them to sign into her account. It's allowing them to hack. It's allowing them to sign into her accounts and things of that nature. But why this question here, the spirit is asking, why get so comfortable with a cousin like that? Why get so comfortable with a friend also? Why get so comfortable with these people? She's got like some type of interesting level of trust that she thinks she has between her and a cousin or a friend. But it keeps giving me this idea of them abusing that friendship because they're dispersing her. They're this a drug dealer. They're dispersing her information to a drug dealer. The drug dealer has some type of really interesting hookup with someone that can make fake IDs. That's how they're able to get in and sign in and withdraw however much money they want from her. They messed me up. They're going in and they're signing it and they're getting whatever. But for some reason, someone's really interested about this. This is like a question. How does she not notice? Or how did that could be a question that she had for herself. She could be how did I not notice? What they were doing also? How did I not notice or see what they were doing? That's a question that's a question she had for Queen of Cups energy. Like how can I not notice that was happening? How can I not notice that she was writing something down? The direct interaction with this person and they're writing her address down. Direct interaction with this person. They're writing her social down. But it's so that they could make an ID, go to someone and get a fake ID made so they could get into her account, her friend, a cousin, or something's going on with a friend or a cousin, their affiliate came into the salon to get fake this, that, and the third done. But they really, I see what's going on. Somebody else that may have been in cousin's friend, somebody else that was in the salon that may have been interacting with her cousin's friend may have given her that information. Oh, I see what's going on here. If she's got a situation here where, man, she also has a situation here also where someone that she worked with, like I'm just giving this example, someone that she worked with, felt comfortable with, someone that she worked with directly, like someone else, another woman that had a seat in her store that she shared information, another woman that had a seat in her salon, she shared some sort of private in our banking or something about that they may have had that kind of agreement, like a lease or something. They may have had that kind of agreement she may have had that kind of agreement with another female that, or however many of those females, that was renting out a seat, that was rent as a stylist, that another stylist that she shared account with, another stylist she could have shared an account with, or another stylist in her salon she could have shared account information with, for the salon, or they could have discussed them sharing. She had an account for the salon, yes. So, I see what's going on here. She could have had a separate account for the salon, but another stylist in the salon asked for that information. Another stylist in the salon asked for that information, asked to do something jointly, asked to have joint access into the salon's account, made that mistake. That may have been a mistake that she made. That was a mistake, because that person, that's why I said friend or cousin, I don't know if their friend or cousin worked in the salon, but that's separate. I feel like what's going on with a friend and a cousin, I feel like that's separate. I feel like it's three different situations between a friend and or a cousin and a female and one account information and a female that is a stylist that is renting out a seat. They wanted the account information or the banking information for the salon. The salon had its own account, but another stylist in the salon wanted that account. I didn't want to share, or that could be the Six of Cups. The Queen of Cups energy could be there could be multiple energies coming off of this one card. Queen of Cups energy could be one of the women that was renting out a seat in the salon. But they stole. One of the women that was a stylist in the salon, that was renting out a seat as a stylist in her salon, their affiliate. Something's also going on with their affiliate. So they're asking her for some type of joint access. They're asking her, but it's supplies also. Someone could have asked. She could have given someone that kind of permission so that another stylist could have access to a card some type of credit card that she had linked to the bank account for the salon. She could have given that to another stylist in the store. So that stylist abused that situation also. That one other stylist is a drug dealer. That one other stylist is connected to a drug dealer. That one other stylist is just willy-nilly. They're just buying whatever they want. That stylist that's renting out a seat is talking to Destiny and telling Destiny, I think we need more supplies for the store. I know you have to take your daughter to take care of your daughter and do this, that, and the third for your daughter. I'll handle this for you. So why don't you just give me the account information for the salon? Wasn't using intuition. Why don't you just give me the account information for the salon? Destiny wasn't using her intuition into what another stylist in the salon was going to do with the information. The stylist ended up dispersing the information to her own friend, or something is also going on there. The drug dealer energy could be a situation where a stylist in her salon is fake asking her, can I have access so we could buy more supplies for the salon, but drug money, but they really need it for drug money. They really need it to buy weed. They really need it to buy coke, whatever it is, whatever. Why did you hire? Someone's going on the spirit. Somebody's asking, why hire her? Like, what, how she ended up hiring, but didn't do background checks. So she may not have been doing background checks on the women that were renting the women that were renting seats in her salon as stylists. She may not have been doing background checks on them. For some reason, she may not have been. Queen of Cups energy could be one of them. However many of them, the Queen of Cups energy could be one of them that was doing that kind of craziness with her, that was doing some kind of craziness with her, with her information for her salon accounts, an account that she had linked to her salon. They may have wanted access to it to get money for weed. They may not have wanted to use their own money. Their own money to buy weed or whatever it is, drug that they needed. whatever it is that they needed. But it's crazy. She may not have been doing. She didn't get a chance to, or she didn't know. That's why I said well-versed from the beginning. She may not have been doing, or may not even have known how to do background checks on certain people here as well. Or that could be mother. That could be something that her mother didn't teach her, or the mother could have been. That could be something that the mother recommended that she do, or she may not have known how to do whatever it is. She had to, the mother could have been on the verge of taking her to do that. And oh, I see what's going on here. The mother could have been. She could have been in a situation here where she could have ended up breaking down and telling the mother this was happening inside of my store with these women that I just hired these women in here. And she's finding out something really shady. She's finding out something really shady. Like I said from the beginning, with two men outside in conversations, and a man and woman outside having conversations, you know, about her information for her salon. And that's why she was fearing and having the paranoid feeling, the nervousness days prior. Because of these conversations, money deals, because of conversations about money deals and her bank account information, her salon address. Why are these two people that I've never seen? Or that's what her energy is like. I don't know these two people, but she's not using intuition that those two people that are stalking her, they're having conversations outside, directly outside or across the street, a diagonal from her at the salon. They're interconnected to a stylist in the salon that's renting out a seat to use. So that's the mistake that she made with hiring certain people, not doing background checks on certain people here. That's one of the issues. A cousin, a friend, somebody that was renting out one of those elements could have rented out they're renting out a seat in her salon to be a stylist. But more than one of them. So when I said more than one of them that was working in her, devious. More than one of them that was working in her salon was devious. They're devious because they're gaining this kind of access, and they're dispersing the account information for drug money or their own needs. Those affiliates' needs, drug needs, or regular household supply, self needs, whatever it was. There's a greedy interconnection between people here. It's crazy. And she's like, why are people coming in my salon trying to snap pictures? Why are people standing outside of my salon? This could be like a drug dealing situation directly outside, but a random, it may have looked on the outside, it may have looked like a separate drug dealing situation, but she's not high priestess. She doesn't know that that situation is interconnected to the store, interconnected to her salon money because of somebody that's renting out a seat to go to jail. Two of those women that they're renting out her seat as a stylist in her salon. Two of them need to go to jail. Whoever they are, whatever. The accomplishment has the sign of Sag. Temperance energy is here. So something could be going on here with a Sagittarian energy. You got Sag, you got Libra, you got I get clients also. So when I said Sag and Libra, something's going on there with one of those elements. Could be a client. The Queen of Cups energy, I feel like, is a cousin slash friend slash could also be a stylist in the salon asking for money. Asking for access to accounts for the store, for the salon, this, that, and the third. But somebody is also showing up here. Someone's going on here with one of those, a Libra or a Sag, whatever. One of those, that's why the Seven of Swords energy is here also. Why is a customer asking me something really interesting? She could have had a customer asking her a really cryptic question, something really odd. A picture, oh, I see. It could literally be a picture, but hooked up by someone. That's why I said somebody was hooked up to do something also. A customer that was really cool with one of her stylists. Well, the Queen of Cups energy could be one of the stylists. It could be a Sag element that is a customer of some kind, whatever. They don't have to be. But the spirit was saying customer when I said Libra and Sag, but whatever. But the Sagittarian energy, I keep getting customer. A Sag is like a customer of a drug customer or like a salon customer, but asked her a cryptic question. So they asked her a really cryptic question one day or days prior, whatever. They asked her a really cryptic question, but she did a high priestess energy. I like that the high priestess is right in the center too. I think that's really interesting to even take notice of. But if somebody is a customer, they're asking her a really cryptic, her funds. They're asking her a really cryptic question about her funds. How much do you make after taxes? How much do you think you're going to get after taxes? Somebody hooked up a customer. One of her stylists could have hooked up a customer to ask that, because one of the stylists that worked in the salon may not have wanted to make some time. They may not. Oh, I see what's happening here. Oh, I see what's happening. Wow. Ooh, this is crazy. This is out of control. What I'm going to say, what the spirit is guiding me to say. The energy with her wanted stylist, the energy also of cutting off somebody from early on in the reading, it has something to do with some type of no, or that she gave a stylist that was working in her salon. The stylist, private information, the stylist is asking her for really private information about her IDs and this, that, and the third, whatever it is, so they can open up account. They're trying to do that also so that they can open up an account. Then there's a situation here where a stylist is hooking up a customer. That could be their own. That could be the because, you know, salons, you have the stylist, and then each stylist has their own set of customers. That one stylist is hooking up their customer, asks her question. That one stylist is hooking up their own customer to ask her really cryptic questions about her accounts and things of that nature. What color do you wear? What color? What identification has all to do with her identification, some type of her destiny's identification card, or what she just looked on a particular day, what she's going to be wearing on a particular day, whatever it is. Someone really interested about that, and that can have something to do with the other. That could have something to do with the first part of the situation where she was saying broke in, where she was talking about the break-in that she experienced. Oh, I see what's going on here. The break-in situation that she experienced days prior, or however long before the day they came in and before she passed, somebody needed some type of, this is crazy. Somebody needed some type of precise, could be a combination to something. She could have had something locked up in her salon that she herself wanted access to, but didn't want to give it to a stylist. She may not have wanted to give another stylist access to that. Some type of access that, something that she had really private in the salon, shouldn't have kept in there. Something she had really private in the salon, she shouldn't have kept in there. So another stylist eyeballing that situation. Another stylist was eyeballing something that she kept really private in the salon. She's saying, I shouldn't have kept a safe or whatever it was in the salon, or whatever it is that got stolen, hair pieces and whatever, and she could have, they're expensive, or it's some type of safe that she had something in it, and the customer is asking her what is the combination. But I get a sequence of numbers. The customer is trying to gather, like, something's going on here. Something happened for a while also. I just got pulled to say that something has been happening. Something was happening with her like this for a while. Like, I don't know if this is the beginning of the year or whatever. Something like that interesting was happening to her for a while, where somebody's trying to gather a sequence. They're trying to get her to give them a sequence of numbers to try them, to get into a combination, whatever it is. Accounts, some type of account, something that she kept in the store. It could even, if it's not a safe or an account also, it could even be where something is in the salon that she may not have wanted certain people to really see or take notice of for some reason. Something that she had in the salon, some type of really private thing, whatever. Or she could have kept her really expensive orders in a particular area of the salon. You know what I mean? And that could be where another stylist wanted to find out where that was in the store, but hooked up somebody. Every time I said it, they hooked up someone. They hooked up someone. And another stylist And another stylist, oh, I see what's going on here. I understand what's happening. She kept something, she kept really, one situation, she kept, like, really, she kept, like, really, her really expensive orders in one section of the, in one section, or in a really a private back room of the store, whatever. She kept, like, really separate stuff. She kept really expensive, certain things she kept that were really expensive in a certain area of the store, but shared that with stylists. So when I said she shared that with a stylist, but what's happening here with it is that she wouldn't give that particular stylist the account information for the salon, what they're doing is hooking up their boys. What they're doing is they're hooking up their friends or some dudes or whatever to go into the salon and steal whatever it is that they need and resell it. And that's how another stylist benefits. That's how another stylist ended up benefiting from a situation as well. But High Priestess, she doesn't know. For some reason she's unaware, or she's not using her intuition that a stylist was trying to steal something from her. But the stylist didn't want to make something obvious. The stylist is having conversations with someone else. It could either it's a customer that did that. It could literally be a customer that did that. The stylist need is something that the customer did. It has something to do with one of the stylists. They needed something there. They needed something. And them needed something ended up led into them hooking up people to break into the store. To get something. But the reason for rejection, the reason for it is because she rejected some type of situation with allowing somebody else to access the account for the store, some type of account, whatever it is. So what their revenge is that they know where certain things are in the store, and they feel rejected because she's not giving them favoritism and sharing the account information for the salon with them. So what they're doing is they know where she keeps the really expensive things that she orders for the store. So what they're, that's why I said supplies earlier on in the reading. They know where she keeps that stuff. So what they're doing is they're hooking up their boys to break in and steal. So they could, that's their way. That is the stylist's way of, oh my God, it's so convoluted. That is the stylist's way of getting a pay. That's the stylist's way of getting the pay that Destiny, getting the pay out of the account that Destiny is saying that she didn't want to share the account information for the salon. She's telling, why do you need this, that, and the third money? Somebody feels rejected by her because of the money situation. She's having a conversation with another stylist. I don't think it's a good idea for me to disperse my account information for the salon to you. I don't think it's a good idea that I do that. So they're taking a revenge, and they know where certain things, they work there. So they know where certain things are in the store. So they're hooking up their boys to go in the back of the store and take this, that, and the third. That's the way that multiple stylists are getting money, whatever it is. She was thinking smart. You know, I'm not going to disperse my salon account information to them. Why would I do something like that? Why would I do that? And some of them are getting upset to the point where they're trying to take pictures of her. They're trying to make fake IDs. They're trying to make fake identification cards of her. They're trying to, what's another situation? They're trying to, she rejected them by giving them access to the salon's account. Why do they need that? So because of the rejection, they know where certain things are in the salon, and they're hooking up people to go rob and take out that stuff there. They're hooking up people to take out that stuff there so that they can sell it to that was their way of getting money back for some reason. But I get this idea. I get this feeling of a refund also. Something wrong could have happened there with a customer. Something happened odd like that with a customer. whatever it is, something that a customer may have felt cheated out by something for some reason. A customer is like interconnected to a stylist. And she, oh, I see what's happening. Another situation. This is a lot. She could have been doing one person's hair, didn't like. She could have done one person's hair, and they may not have. She may have messed up something with somebody's hair or somebody's skin. Whatever it is that she did with somebody, with a customer. So what they feel betrayed. A customer felt betrayed for some reason. I don't know if she had some type of, I don't know if she was talking to somebody rudely. I don't know what some, I don't, she had some type of interesting interaction with a customer. So that customer, this, you know what's really interesting? This is really interesting. It's really interesting. Like, it's really, that's why I said somebody mentally and sociopathic and whatever it is happening. Someone interesting is going on here with a customer Someone's going on with a customer with weave. Some type of issue that a customer had with weave. But it has something to do with the quality of the weave, or like something stupid, like the quality of the weave or the length of the weed. I would say weed. If someone's going on with the weed, yes. The length, somebody could have been smoking weed before acting stupid. But something's going on where, like, something could have been going on with somebody's hair every time I go on these examples, I keep getting conserve. She may have been trying to conserve her really quality, like really expensive quality things, and she may have been cheap. Or give somebody some, however you want to look at it. I don't know how weaves are. I don't know. She may have been trying to conserve the really expensive things for like later on or during the holiday season, whatever it was. She may have been trying to conserve certain hair and things for a certain time period of the year. But somebody may have been deeming something to be cheap that was done, like some client or something. And the client may have felt that way and could have pulled another stylist aside to have some type of discussion, to have some type of really interesting discussion there with another, that's why something happened. A client complained about some foolishness with hair quality and whatever it is. And her giving them something cheap. It could even be pay, or something going on with quality and conserving money and whatever it was. It's something's going on there with they. That's why something happened. A client. Something happened heavy because of some type of client need, some type of complaint that a client had. But at weave quality, and some do also crazy with weave quality. So that client is pulling another stylist aside. And they're having conversations with the stylist. Do you know? Oh, I see what's happening here. This is out of control. This is a lot. Like, this is crazy. Okay, there's a client. I keep getting weave quality. There's a client that is, like, complaining about weave quality, foolishness, that someone mentally is going on with somebody complaining about weave quality, whatever, sociopathic, whatever is going on with them. They complain about weave quality. So what's happening here is that that one client is getting really comfortable with another stylist that knows, it's taking me on this idea of a bribe. The client complaining about weave quality, they're getting really comfortable with another stylist in the store that knows where certain things are, that knows where the good weave is, or the good whatever is in the store. They know where that is. So what's happening, that's why this is a lot, what's happening between the client and the other stylist is because the client just happens to be also feels cheated out. The client also happens to be interacting with the stylist early on in the reading that felt cheated out because she's not giving them salon account access. That stylist may just know where certain things are in the store. So agreeing with client. So when I hit that note, they're agreeing with the client. The client I'll ultimatum. The client is talking to them, giving them an ultimatum and things of that nature. You know, I know these dudes that could rob, that could get me the quality hair that I want, whatever it is. So that's a conversation that a client ended up having with another stylist. But that stylist just so happened to be that stylist that the client, that the complaining client is talking to, just happens to be the stylist that Destiny said she didn't want to give the information to. So they pretty much, between the stylist and the client, they pretty much tag teamed, because of whatever issue, they pretty much tag teamed to get what they wanted. And they both ended up getting what they wanted in terms of hair quality and money, whatever it is, because they in secretive business deal together. They may have been in the secretive business deal together, a client and one of those stylists. It's really shady. It's a really shady situation. And they could have ended up selling the hair, using the hair, whatever it is, using the hair, selling the hair together behind the scenes. Wow. Jeez. The Empress energy is here. This will be her. She was an Aries element, and her spiritual self right next to the Queen of Cups energy. So Aries, I feel like there's a Libra, double Libra. The Empress would be Libra and Aries element. You got Libra here. You got Sag here. You got Queen of Cups energy here as water sign energies. There's a lot of females here. There's a lot of females here. Hooked up dudes. Females that hooked up dudes. There's females that hooked up dudes to over hair, over account access, over nonsense, over selling hair, whatever it is, over favoritism and feeling rejected and nonsense, jealousy, envy, whatever it is. Because she wouldn't give a stylist access to a private closet, like some type of private closet, some type of closet that she had locked with all the expensive stuff in it. She may have just wanted to be the only one to access that closet, access that safe, access that account. Then why, Tizzle Cups Energy, why do you keep asking me for this account access? Why do you keep asking me key? Why do you keep asking me for this key? I'm not giving you this key. Whatever it is. So they felt betrayed. They're feeling rejected. Then there's a client that is complaining. I keep getting hair quality. Then there's a client complaining about hair quality. Some type of nonsense like that. Some type of hair quality. Something mentally is going on with the client. And the client feels cheated out because the client is aware, because of the stylist in the salon, the client is aware that she's got a closet. She's got a closet full of quality hair or full of whatever, Indian, whatever you want to call it, Indian hemp hair, whatever, some foolishness like that. This could be a situation here where the clients aren't supposed to know where certain, the clients are not supposed to know what's inside of certain closets in the salon. And that could be something that one of the stylists, or that however many of the stylists, that could be something that the stylist did. The stylist revealed to the clients that they're not supposed to know that. They're not supposed to. So one situation is that they want their hair to look nice, but they're being given cheap styles, whatever. It's crazy. Or that's one situation. But somebody was also on, some type of client was also on drugs and or something's wrong with them mentally, and they want to sell the jealousy and the envy, whatever is going on with them. They want to sell the bundles. They want to sell the hair. They want to sell the nail things, whatever it is that she has that was really expensive that she kept, but should have kept at home. It was expensive. She's thinking she should have kept it at home, whatever it is. And people are complaining about that, and people are hooking up dudes, their boys, to break in and get it and sell it. Madness. Clients and stylists tag teaming, secretive business deals. To get a business deals, meaning to get in. That's why she wasn't giving passwords and passwords. She wasn't giving anybody keys to certain closets. The clients are not supposed to know where the expensive stuff are being kept in the salon. She's like, I should have kept that stuff at home. Seven of Swords. I should have took that stuff home. I should have kept it at home. Whatever it was. But this energy being in her, if it's not only her energy, Empress energy could be the energy of her mother. You know what I mean? Her mother could have ended up coming up to the store at some point, whatever it was. She just needed to, it's in her spiritual side. So she missed her mom. She misses her mother. You know what I mean? She misses her mother and things of that nature. She misses them. She missed her mother. That's why the mother, that's why the Empress, Aries, or she missed her mother. She also misses being her mother, being with her baby. She was taken away from her baby because of Queen of Cups, because of a client. I'm touching this card also. I also get narcissists. Something narcissistic about Queen of Cups energy. Something narcissistic there. You know? They took her. They had some type of plan between stylists, between drug dealers, between clients. They all set up something crazy. Whatever it is. They set up something really crazy on her. The mentality has the Magician card. I don't know if the news necessarily talked about... I'll have to look at it. I'm not sure. I'm just doing this based on general channeling. But the news may not have said anything about... they could have briefly... I don't know if they briefly said anything about her stylist. But cause of murder. Stylists are cause of the murder here. Like, it's their fault. Like, they... It's their fault is because they... It's because of who they hooked up. It's because of who they hooked up to do something. Because of favoritism, her not giving them access to the salon's account that she had for the salon. They're talking to clients. The clients are complaining over nonsense, whatever it is. But jealousy and envy is like the undertone of that, you know, jealousy and envy, because somebody could have been older that was working for her. Also, somebody, the Empress energy could be another Aries or a Libra, another Libra female that one of these, however many of these elements, they work in the salon, that they're, one of them could have been older than her. One of them could have been older than her. And them being couldn't obtain, them being older than her, they may not have been able to obtain something that she was able to obtain. And it could be her, it could just be her business by itself. That could be where all the complaining kept coming from. But manage something better. So when she managed something better than they did. Somebody that she had working in her salon. Someone that she had working in her salon could have been older or the same age group. That somebody that she had working in the salon with her, they envious. Yes, keep telling me, and they were envious. But one of the reasons they tried, somebody tried to obtain. Okay, what she had, somebody else also tried. That's why they were in the store. What she had going well for herself, that other person, that other woman, however many those other women, they tried to obtain that exactly the way she did, but they failed to do so. And they watched her do that over, they watched her triumph over them in that way. And that's why they did something. You know? Oh, I see what's going on here. That's crazy. It's out of control. Jesus Christ. This is a lot of information. I'm glad that I went on that example to explain that, because what's happening with them, that's interesting that I went on that example. Somebody that hiring process also, Jesus Christ, something that's going on here with a hiring process or somebody, you know, her Facebook page. I think I checked her Facebook page and I saw some type of older post that she had where she needed stylists, but she needed stuff. Something's going on with high school. So it's giving me like a high school feeling. I don't know if she ended up hiring someone that she was in high school with, or someone that she went to high school with. They set up something. Someone that she went to high school with set up something. Someone that she went to high school with, they could have applied to work in her salon. And that could be where the background checks and things of that nature were coming from also. But she, something's going on with, like, she could have put up a post. I'm trying to understand what the spirit wants me to say. She put up a post to have certain, she put up a general post to look for stylists to work in the salon, but she had some type of interesting run-in with them in the past or something interesting like that. She had like a really interesting, she had an interesting run-in with, that's what a high priestess energy is here. She doesn't know. She had, oh my God. God, I don't even know where to begin with this example. She had, like, in the past, she had, and didn't recognize them. She had an interest in running with another female in the, some female in the past that she... That she had, okay, that she had some type of interesting running with, or was dealing with men. So when I said that someone's gone there, she, some type of, some, a running that she had with a female in the past, either destiny was dealing with that woman, was dealing with that woman, their man. Something interesting like that. She may have been dealing with their men, but someone's gone, also, something's gone on there with a client. So that something there, the client interconnected to that. The client is interconnect. Jesus Christ. The client is interconnected to that knowledge. Because somebody that is applying to work in her store used to, she either used to be with their man or she had a child. Oh my God. My God, Lord have mercy, it's a lot. She had a lot of stuff going on here, boy. The father, I don't know if this is like the father of her child, their ex, or the father of her child, a woman. Okay, the father of her child, a woman that they were tied to. A woman that they were tied to after her. A woman that they, her, the father of her child, or some dude that she was dealing with in the past, whatever. Or it is the, it could be the father of her child. A woman applied to work in store. A woman that he was tied to applied to work in her store. But High Priestess, that's why I said from the beginning, somebody keeps coming in. She doesn't know ex-girlfriend looks like. She doesn't know, she didn't know what the father of her child, what his ex-girlfriend looked like. She didn't know what she looked like. For some reason, she didn't know what she looked like, or she didn't know of her, or there's more than one of them. She said that the father of her child had more than one ex, had more than one woman that he was dealing with. But she, some of those women, or however many of those women, they're showing up here. Some of those women, they are, they're like interconnected to her cousin. They're interconnected to a customer, and they're doing really shady deals. And, but another situation here, she never met or she didn't know what they look like. Or one, she didn't know what one kept coming into the salon. She didn't know what one of them looked like, but they kept coming into the salon. They kept coming in, but he cheated. She's saying that he cheated. Like, I don't know what the sign of the father for child is. She's saying that he cheated at one point. And the person that he, one of those women that he cheated on destiny. Okay. He either cheated on destiny. That's also what's called the problem. He could have cheated on destiny. Yes. He could have cheated on destiny, but the girl that he cheated on destiny with stalking, that he cheated on destiny with ended up stalking her, but their stalk, she, what, that could be the one that she's saying that she doesn't know what they look like, or that's a different one that she knows what they look like. She doesn't know what they look like. They could have came into multiple times. They could have come into, they could have come into her salon multiple times for this, that, and the third need. But she doesn't know what they look like. That's why I said taking pictures. But they try to do that. Taking pictures. That's the girl that they tried to do that. Then there's another scenario here also with either destiny, the father of, either destiny was with the father of her child and he cheated again. She was with the father of her child, and what's going on with it is that he cheated. He may have been with someone before he was with her, or the father of her child, he may have been with a girl already. That could be how she ended up pregnant. He already had a side chick. He had some type of side chick attached to him that she's saying she didn't know, or she didn't know what they looked like. So follow her. They were following her, like, online, or following her on the street. They were following her online because passing. So when they caused her passing, one of them, however many of them that the boyfriend, her boyfriend, the father of her child was dealing with, they ended up, what do you call it? One of those women may have ended up working, but I didn't see. One of those women ended up working in the salon with her. And they end up working in this, hence the reason for the jealousy and the rejection and the accounts. And that was their jealous, envious way of being really close. Usually when people are like jealous and envious of someone, especially if a man is involved in the situation, they're going mentally, something mentally going on with that. What they try to do is to get really close to the girl that they're leaving them for, to get really close to the girl that the man is leaving them for. And whoever the father of her child is, a woman that he was dealing with, a woman that he had, that the spirit said side woman, a woman that he had attached to him, but was a woman he had attached, he wasn't paying attention to, a woman that he had attached, a separate woman that he had attached to him, he wasn't paying attention to. So he wasn't paying attention to that woman. So that he thus far goes to destiny, but found some type of solace in her. Like he found her to be more nurturing than somebody that he was dealing with. And that other woman that she's saying that he rejected applied to store. She ended up applying to the store. She ended up applying to the store, applying to work in the store. But it could be multiple of them that he, it could be multiple of them. The father of, I mean, he did the same, I feel like he did the same thing to her, but more so them. He could have done the same thing to her, but they, that was more so them had that kind of issue with the father of her child. So what's happening here is that they feel betrayed. She, one situation, she didn't know what one of them looked like. However many of them, she doesn't know what they look like. And they're, or she didn't do background checks. They're applying to work in her store. Accepted them. They're applying to work in the store. She accepted them. She either knows what they look like or she doesn't know what they look like. And they're devising, because they feel betrayed by the father of her child, they're devising plans against her with clients. Wow, it's a lot. The Magician card is in the mentality, so I went on that whole explanation after I put the Magician card down. You know what I mean? I went on that example when I put the Magician energy here in the mentality. You know, so the Magician with the Seven of Swords, figuring out something. The Magician with the Seven of Swords is figuring out probably that I said just now. That's why the High Priestess is here in the present. She's using her intuition. She's using her intuition that a boyfriend, that the father of her child, her saying that he cheated. If he cheated on her, he could have been currently with that woman that he cheated on destiny with. She was stalking. So when I said she was stalking, she applied in my store, or he was with destiny, or he was also when he was with destiny, a woman that he was leaving for destiny applied to store. A woman that he was leaving for destiny applied to her store. One of those women, however many of those women, she saying that she didn't know what they look like, they're applying to her store. They're applying to her store. She's end up accepting one of them or however many of them into the store. So they're obviously out of jealousy and envy, they're devising plans against her. They're jealous and envious of that, of her success. But what's making the jealousy and envy even worse is because if she's with her man. If her man is what it's looking like is somebody had low self-esteem, obviously. Somebody had really low self-esteem. But the father of her child, if he's leaving or he's just dealing with two women at the same time, he's dealing with two, her being, destiny being one of those women. He's leaving that other woman for success. Destiny is successful. That other woman or that however many of those women, they may not have been lackadaisical. They may have been really lackadaisical in life. Or they may not have been successful. They may have been nobodies. You know what I mean? They may have been nobodies. And they were nobodies. That could be how the boyfriend or the father of her child observed them to be. Hence the reason for the leaving and the cheating, whatever it is. Those other women may not have been as ambitious as she was. Driven as she was. Hence the boyfriend leaving them for her. but the boyfriend, she's also saying the boyfriend cheated. She's saying that the boyfriend could have also cheated on her as well. She could have ended up in a single mother kind of situation at one point. She did or she did not. I don't know if they didn't really say anything much about boyfriend. I don't know if they did or they did not. But they, again, this high priestess, this is like a gang up on her kind of from all ends of the spectrum. People needed money. Cousin needed money. Cousin affiliates. Some of the interest that's going on with a cousin's affiliate is one of the, and it could also be one of the women that the boyfriend was dealing with. Everybody's like in close proximity to each other. It's not like this is like a small town. Interconnections between people. So I would believe that the cousin would know one of the boyfriend's exes, one of the boyfriend's women, whatever it is, somebody the boyfriend was dealing with. The cousin may have known about, but she may not have the cousin themselves may not have even known that. That's why the high priestess is there. She's asking the cousin, who do you need money for? Then this situation's here with the stylists are perpetrators. The stylists in the salon are perpetrators. They're perpetrators because rejection. That's why I said earlier on, they're perpetrators because of rejection. Wow. What's changing is the King of Wands energy. So you have Sag here. So this could be a Leo male, Aries male, whatever fire sign energy. That's a male. I don't know if this is her. This energy could be one of the perpetrators. This could be, I don't know if that's the energy of her boyfriend. Somebody could, I always say embody. When I say embody, that means that I don't know what the sign of the boyfriend is. You know what I mean? I don't know what the sign of the killers are. You know what I mean? So they're supposed to manage something also. The King of Wands was supposed to manage something. They could be a police. If they're someone that's supposed to manage something for her, they could be an investigator. They could also be an investigator. They could be a police officer, but didn't do their job. Police officer that didn't do their job. She's saying they didn't do their job well. Or that they just didn't do their job, period. Whatever it is, they didn't do their job. Could be a Sag, you know? Or it's a Leo, or whatever fire sign energy, that's a male. They didn't do their job for some reason. She could have been paying them. I would see that she would have enough money to hire a private investigator. That's why I said coming into the store, if it's not a client or someone that wanted her IDs and things of that nature, that happened. She said that something odd like that did happen. But this energy literally could be a private investigator that came into the store to take pictures and observe and question and whatever. But they're like undercover. Or they had to be undercover. Someone had to be undercover in order for that to even work. They had to be undercover. You know? And either she hooked them up, but they were separate also. She could have hooked them up, but the spirit is also saying that if that is someone that did do that, they're also separate. Oh, I see what's happening here. If the King of Wands energy is like an investigator of some kind, if the King of Wands energy is an investigator of some kind, they hooked up by someone else. They are an investigator that they're hooked because of the drugs. She didn't hook them up. They were hooked up by someone else, or they just came out of nowhere because it's the element. See, she is the high priestess. She's unintentionally creating some type of element. She's creating a drug element here by accident. Because affiliations, she's unintentionally creating a drug element surrounding her store because of affiliations and people needing drug money. And that being one of the reasons somebody broke into her store. But the reason for it is because of some type of leeway. Some type of leeway that she gave to a cousin, some type of leeway that she gave to somebody. Whatever it is, she could have broke down. She could have been in a situation here where she's constantly telling someone no, no, no. She could have ended up breaking down and giving someone password. She ended up breaking down and giving someone password. And this could have something to do with her accounts and being tampered with and whatever it is. You know? Her accounts and credit cards being missing and stolen. You know? So she's hiring. She could ask somebody to do private investigation to find her things. you know? And something about that caused killing, that caused the passing. Or her getting someone to investigate caused her, because somebody is now nervous. There's elements that are getting nervous. The women in the store are getting nervous. They're getting nervous. The stylist and their fault. The stylist is their fault. They're becoming nervous. Because they're the ones that hooked up the people to come and shoot her. Like they're the ones that hooked up the dudes to come and shoot, go in there and do that. For a number of foolishness of reasons, because of the man being the father of her child, leaving the father of her child cheating on her, the father of her child cheating on someone else to be with her, hooking up, or something going on with clients and cheapness in hair and hair quality and money and having access to certain closets and whatever. There's a lot of different interesting scenarios, but one heavy reason is that the father of her child keeps giving that idea. One heavy reason is the father of her child leaving someone, but that woman is like applying to her store, or they were trying to apply to her store, or she had them in her store. The boyfriend, with the father of her child was dealing. The father of her child may have been dealing with one of the stylists, but didn't see. So when I said I didn't see that happening. So I didn't see that. I didn't see, you know? Oh. So this element is like, she's aggravated and she's finding out all these things. And she, why aren't you doing your job? She's like, why aren't you, King wants her interaction with them. Why aren't you doing your job? Why aren't you doing your job to for some reason she's not thinking. Something's end up going over her head with the fact that she, or over his head, whoever, something ended up happening with that where she didn't see for some reason who she's hiring. That could have been a discussion that they had with her, or their findings. So when I said it has something to do with their findings. So they could have found out that who she hired, that could be something that happened now. That could, who they're bringing back that, I don't know if that some part of that element could be happening now. Their findings have to do with perpetrators. Their findings, like they're looking for the perpetrators, but in her salon. Every time I said the perpetrators, yes, they and the dudes, whoever, they're males or whatever, they came into her salon, but it's like what's missing from the investigation, stylists, what's missing from the investigation are the stylists. The stylists are perpetrators. The stylists are connected to the perpetrators. And that's what's missing. Kim Wan's energy, that's what they're missing. So there's multiple people that stylists. There's multiple people. Spirit keeps seeing stylists. The stylists need to be arrested. The stylists need to go to jail. The stylists need to go to prison. Whatever it is going on there. Whatever it is. Some stylists. One of them or however many of them. Hooked up someone to go in there and shoot up the situation, you know. But I keep looking at them; they're not working. This could be energy that is happening now with investigations and whatever it is. And they're missing the information. They just keep missing information. They keep missing information. It's right under their nose. The answers they need are right under their nose. For some reason, they're not. I also get clientele. For some reason, they're not questioning the clientele that came into the salon. They're not questioning. But I get this idea. I also get this feeling of a salon owner. I don't know if somebody is already in the works of taking over her salon. Somebody could be. It keeps ringing in my ear. Somebody could be in the works of taking. I don't know if cousin or whoever. I don't know. Somebody could be in the works of taking over her salon, buying it, renting, whatever they're doing with that. Somebody could be in the works of, but one of the women, somebody could be in the works of taking over the salon, like now. Like somebody could be in the works of doing that right now. Like that could be something that one of those women are doing. That could be something that one of those women are doing, one of those stylists are doing. But that was their plan. One of the stylists could be in the works of doing that, but that was their plan to do that for a while. That was their plan to take her out and take over her what she worked for. But for some reason, not seeing that. For some reason, Kim Wan's energy is not seeing that. For some reason. They're not seeing that. They're an investigator. They're a police officer. Whatever it is that they are. They're not seeing it for some reason. They're not seeing it. You know? They're not seeing that. Those interactions. But either some... I keep touching this card. Either they need to question this. I keep getting the idea of a salon owner. Somebody could be in the works of taking over her salon just like that. But they may need to... Whoever that is, they may need to question that person. Or they need to question the stylist. Somebody could be trying to take over a salon now. And that person needs to be questioned. But orchestration, that person needs to be questioned. Whoever that is, or they orchestrated the situation like this to happen to her. They orchestrated it. And it could be one of the other stylists or some other person that one of those stylists know. Something interesting like that. Someone of the cousin knows. Their affiliation. I feel like the cousin just wanted money. And somebody there that's tied to the cousin could be trying to own the salon. Is the cousin trying to take over the salon? I don't know. Something interesting could be happening like that. You know, KM1 is not using an intuition tactic. They're not using an intuition about some type of really interesting tactic that a cousin has or a cousin's friend has or some stylist that they have. Or that somebody's not thinking that deeply. Somebody's just trying to look for the shooters, but they're not looking to who hooked up the shooters. They're not looking for who hooked up the shooters. Who hooked up the shooters would be like the real crime. They're paying and bribing people to do that. They're right under his nose. They work in the salon. They're the women that work in the salon. But they're friends. The women that work in the salon, they're friends. Their friends are the ones that pull trigger. Whatever it is, something crazy like that. The resolution has the sign of Gemini. So yeah, Gemini, you got Libra. You know, some of these elements, the Queen of Cups energy, cousin, mom energy is here. You got Sag element here. You got King of Wands, Leo, male, whatever kind of fire sign energy that's a male. Aries, Sag, male, whatever. It could be more than one investigator, you know. But the Gemini energy is in the resolution going towards the Justice card. Yeah, Gemini, this lover's energy, partnership. It could be a partnership she had with a Libra. Or it's just justice, you know. But something's going on interesting. But it's telling me the investigation. Something interesting is going on with the investigation. Like something interesting with that has more information. The investigation has more information. They have more information now. You know, they have more information now, but it's almost like she could have been dealing with Gemini. Gemini energy, I don't know if the Gemini energy is one of the workers. Gemini, you got Libra here. You know what I mean? She's going to try to confide in some of these elements as well. They're in the future. But a part of investigation, these elements are in the future. They're a part of an investigation. That's why lovers, a partnership, that lovers energy is here. Libra energy, justice, they're a part of an investigation. They're a part of it. They're a part of the Seven of Swords and the instincts. They're a magician. She wanted Gemini a part of an investigation. That's why Seven of Swords is here with the magician. They may or may not be in an investigation yet. They're not. But she saying that she would prefer them to be. She would prefer a Gemini to be in an investigation of some type. They could be another police officer. They could be a friend with information. They could be a friend with information. You know? Whatever it is that they are. Kim Wands. Got information. They got information, but overlooking something on purpose. They could be overlooking something on purpose. Kim Wan's energy. That's why they're in a changing position. The Gemini energy may do a better job. The Gemini energy could be someone that is being hooked up to do something now. Whatever. That's why K-1s, whatever it is that they're doing, but asked to do something on purpose. They're being asked to overlook something on purpose. They're being asked to overlook it on purpose. Leo, Aries, whatever fire sign energy is, a male. They're being asked to look over the situation on purpose, some part of it on purpose, whatever it is. But she would prefer a Gemini or Libra, somebody to be in the investigation. But they have information. A Gemini or a Libra have information. She would prefer them to be in the investigation. Or they are in it, whatever it is. You know? Queen of Cups energies. Somebody showed up, stylist. Dangerous. Someone's dangerous about the stylist. Someone's going on mentally, neurologically with somebody with envy and jealousy and money and not giving them. And not, she's not realizing that who her boyfriend is dealing with. She's not realizing that who her boyfriend was dealing with is, what do you call it? Who her boyfriend is dealing, I don't know if the element is her, I don't know what her boyfriend's sign is. That could be what, that her boyfriend could be embodying King of Wands. If that's not their sign, they could be, her boyfriend could be embodying King of Wands betrayal. Her boyfriend could be her embodying King of Wands energy because of betrayal. Because of betrayal. But the betrayal, not really his fault. The betrayal may not really be his fault. It's just who he had attached to him. Who he had attached to him that she's ended up hiring, that she's not realizing vendetta. Who he had attached to him, she's not realizing that she's hiring and they have some type of crazy vendetta on her. But they're like the real perpetrators. The stylists. One of those stylists. Queen of Cups energy. You got Queen of Cups energy here. You got Sag. You got Gemini. You got Libra. You got a lot. Just whatever. All right. Let's look for an outcome here for her case. Let's see. This is a lot of information. The Tower is a sign of Scorpio. Gervonta Davis, I believe his name is. He was some type of boxer, some type of whatever, wrestling, whatever it is he do. He ended up paying for her funeral, I believe, and he was a Scorpio. Six Cups energy there, a bet. The Scorpio, he was a Scorpio. He ended up putting a bet on her situation here. This is when somebody passes randomly like this that is successful. That is in the light in this way. They are ritual. They are ritual. This is a ritualistic situation. And when somebody pays for the funeral, they're part of the bet. They're paying for the funeral. They're a part of the bet. He is a part of that bet. He's a part of that bet. He's not heavily shown up here because he may have been in communication with somebody. He may have been in communication with. It's a bet situation. It's ritualistic, obviously. It's bet. It's ritualistic that they took her out. That was a bet. That's why they're overlooking something on purpose. They're overlooking something on purpose because it's a bet. It's ritual. It's bet. It's a bet situation. That's why they're not really that knows who really they know who did something. Yes, obviously, if it's a bet and it's ritualistic, they know who did something. They're not going to tell the news they already have answers. They're not going to tell the news they already have answers. Because it's a bet. It's a ritual. They're not going to tell the news one tactic that they do that's really interesting is that they to mislead. They put like bits and pieces, or they add updates and whatever it is they do. They get bits and pieces that they add on to the investigation so that people would pick up the cues, so that people won't pick up the cues. But they add bits and pieces of an update to her case so that people won't pay attention to, they already have the information. So people won't pay attention to the fact that they already have the information. They already know girl setup. They already know that some stylist that she had set up something. They already know the stylists in the store are connected to the shooters, the perpetrators. They know that already. They're responsible for paying for the funeral. They already put their name in the bet to win. That wrestler, whoever, the person that paid for her funeral. The person that paid for her funeral, part of the bet. They already know how the girl, they already know who they're trying to act. What they do with media is that they make it seem, they try to prolong a case so that people, the people, metaphysical bet. I touched K1's energy. It's a metaphysical bet that they're in. But the people that pulled the trigger, the person that shot her, that part of the bet, they're a part of the bet. So they're going to protect it. They're a part of the bet. They're protected. But what's happening with it is that they're going to tell you that they haven't been found. They're gonna prolong the case because they're gonna pick what they're gonna do is they may end in the news however long of an update. They're going to give you pictures of a wrong person. They're gonna possibly even give you to try to give the media pictures of people that are fake people that they're not responsible for the killing. They just want to protect the identities of the real shooters, the real people that killed her. They do that with every news article as to protect the identity of the real perpetrators. They're gonna show you images of real people, that real dudes that were caught. But it may or may not be those real people. But that's how they're a part of the bet. So they're not going to show you the real pictures of those real people. Or they may show you the pictures of them age. They're not gonna give you the real age. They're not gonna give you those people the real name. They're not gonna do that. It's all tactic. It's all systematic tactic that they have designed, especially when they do rituals and bets and things of that nature. They're going to conceal the real identities of the people that really killed her because it's a bet. They're not gonna give you the real information of the real killers. They're not gonna do that. That's just not happening. That's not going to happen that way. They're a whole group. That they set up that to happen like that. They set up people to do that. They may not even show you. They may not even give you the pictures of the women. I keep getting this salon owner. Somebody may own that salon already. But it's a metaphysical bet for her to be gone. So that they could take over. So that whoever that is could take over the store, the salon. They're part of that bet. Somebody may end up receiving the taxes. It could be the person that paid for her funeral received taxes. The person that paid for her funeral, a part of the bet. The bet ensures that they're going to receive the taxes for the salon, that she's not there anymore. The bet is going to ensure the ritual that is going to ensure that they continue to receive the taxes from her salon. They haven't set it up precisely that way to happen like that. It's all by design. Also, the tower energy information. The tower energy is also information. The tower energy is information. It's information here. The tower is information. You know, the tower is water sign energy. This Queen of Cups energy could be a Scorpio. The dude is a Scorpio that paid. That's a part of the bet that paid for her funeral. Anytime you hear about somebody randomly paying for somebody's funeral, you're damn sure that it's bet-like. It's a bet that they joined into. So they're paying for the funeral at 10 times more. They're paying for the funeral. They're receiving 10 times more money after the fact. Her salon, her taxes that she's going to be receiving forever for that place. Somebody's already hooked up to own it. Somebody's already hooked up to run that place. And they're receiving the taxes for the place. Wow. Jeez. Let me do another outcome with the tower. This is 2 hours? You lie. The Nine of Pentacles energy here could be a Taurus. This is only Earth sign energy that's here. It's Earth sign. So the Tower could be tax. The Nine of Pentacles energy is something going on with taxes. It's something's going on taxes with her place. Somebody that is rituals. Tell me ritual. Yes, it's the Nine of Pentacles with the Tower is ritual. This is ritualistic. Obviously, if this is ritualistic, this is a ritualistic bet situation that's happening here. It's ritualistic. People on a run are a part of the ritual. They're not going to tell you. They're going to prolong the case, give you bits and pieces of craziness of updates that are not factual. When I said it, they are not factual. The bits and pieces of updates that they're going to keep giving you, some is fabricated about those updates. Pay attention. Some is fabricated about those updates. It's all ritual. This is what they do. All right. Well, that is Destiny Harrison's case. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, you know where to find me, okay? All right, Destiny, may your spirit go with peace. Be well. Take care. Bye.